Good evening.
Good evening.
Welcome to the 297th Hootenanny. We're fast closing in on number 300. This is actually our 23rd Hootenanny here at the Snow King Center, and they've been good ones. I guess most of the musicians are out on crowd control tonight, and we hope that they and the rest of the crowd will soon be in here. We do encourage as many people who sit back in the audience and who are kind of, shall we call them, closet folk singers, those who have a guitar or the banjo in the closet and who occasionally sing at home. We really wish they would come up here and perform on stage with us. And with the rather light turnouts that we're having now, both with audience and with audience and musicians, I should say, they this would be a good time. So if you know somebody, if you got something out there in the car and you're just wondering, should I bring it in, please go get it and sign up. Love to have some new voices and new blood up here. We have a very light sign up so far tonight, although I just saw Buddy Thompson out there, and there he is, so at least we have some quality with us tonight. And my co-hoot Bill Briggs, who has been so good over the years, 5.5 years now, coming on 6 years in a couple months. Bill always starts the evening out, and it's a tough spot to be the first one up on the stage, especially with not so many people here. So we more appreciate Bill's presence here on a night like this than most nights. Not really any excuses about so few people tonight. I don't know what's, it's certainly not election night. Thank God that's behind us. And I don't know what's on, unless they're rooting for the Broncos or against them. Maybe that's where everybody is. But we are going to go right ahead and have our Hootenanny. And let's see, Bill's the top dog here now, since I was so tardy, irresponsible, and away for a while. Bill, this is now his 262nd appearance here, out of 297. So, Mr. 262 appearance is gonna take the stage, Bill Briggs.
Hey!
Oh, thunderous applause. Oh, dear. Had a phone call this afternoon requesting this song from back east. Well, I can't play it for him here, but I can practice it.
Well, we can put in a phone call.
That's right.
Oh. But it's a fellow that I haven't met yet, but we're arranging a hoot back east in April now. Anyway, I haven't played this on the 12-string guitar for years. Thank you. friend of mine, now his Jeremy's gone. This morning, my best friend lay still in his bed, his face like a jewel, and he was dead. Thank you. And I'm going to send this one back with him too.
Wonderful, neat, old, traditional songs from Bill. I first knew Bill back in gosh, around 1956, 57. And I heard him sing those songs way back then. It's nice to hear him again. Next, we have one of our crowd pleasers. So I don't know why he's here tonight. And I will say for our historic video that we do that doesn't see there aren't so many people here tonight, that that's why I said that, because we have a light audience at this point. Pete Carney started coming here and singing with his brother, and they as a act are extremely entertaining. And he is as entertaining when he's on stage by himself. He does a lot of very lively songs, but he also does some very old and very sentimental songs. They're a few of my favorites. Anyway, we're delighted that he lost his position a month or so ago, as he says, but at least it frees him up to be here on Monday nights, and we other entertainers enjoy hearing him. I hope you do. I know you will. This is Pete Carney.
Hey!
I've never been second. I'm really moving up in the world. And I do sort of feel like, what? What?
You're a butt, that's second.
This probably will be a bun. No, I am feeling sort of like the spot mark X where the accident happened after going one way and my band going the other. And I missed all these great Hootenannies all summer. But, and it's sort of, it's one of the old traditions, I like to get up here and then decide what to do. I'll sing a Mexican song. It's called Malagueña Saladosa. Qué bonitos ojos tienes. Debajo estas tus cejas, debajo estas tus cejas, qué bonitos ojos tienen. Ellas me quieren mirar, perrocito no los dejas, perrocito no los dejas, ni siquiera para brevar. Malequén. Salerosa, besar tus labios quisiera, besar tus labios quisiera, con el candor de una rosa, con el candil de una rosa. Ven, tú no vas a despertar, perro si te no los dejas. Perrocito no los deja, ni siquiera parpadear. Ellos me quieren mirar, perrocito no los deja, perrocito no los deja, ni siquiera parpadear. Malagueña salerosa. Hechicera, de esa linda que hechicera, con el candor de una rosa, con el candil de una rosa.
I forgot half of it.
What does
Malagueña
mean?
It's about Malagueña, it's a girl from Malaga. Yeah. Then there's
Yeah, this is Malagueña Salerosa. There's actually a Malagueña, it's just a straight guitar, but never, it doesn't sound anything like it.
Would you ever let me go in my hometown, where everyone that I meet would see me down? It's not right for you to tell me I must choose and take this life that I love so much or stay with you. Last chance. Romance. Last chance. Romance. My heart is wondering how I'm gonna choose. Last chance. It's my last chance with you. And then she sings, would you ever change your ways, you said to me, when you know, honey, how good I can be? It's not right to tell things that I must choose and take this life I love so much or stay with you. Last chance. Romance. Last chance. Romance. My heart is wondering how I'm gonna choose. Last chance. It's my last chance with you. Last chance. It's my last chance with you.
That's one half of the Carley Brothers. We'll hear the other half later, maybe. Pete Carney, always an entertainment to have him around, whether he sings or not. All right, moving on, we got a fellow back with us again. Gosh, he was missing last week and we really missed him. But he's back and got his voice with him and guitar and he can even walk all right. This is Patrick Troiani.
The seat looks good. The seat looks good. Good job, Pete. Okay, welcome, Doug. And Doug Woody and Hank Phibbs should be. There he is. I don't think there's any really hurry tonight. We're going to do a couple Bob Dylan tunes for you. Simple and easy and pleasant. So. This first one is called The North Country Fair. If you try on the borderline, remember me to one who lives there, for she was once a true love of mine. See for me that her hair hanging down, the curls and falls all down her breast. See for me that her hair's hanging down, for that's the way I remember her best.
where the rivers freeze, summer never ends. Go where those snowflakes fall. You could tell her. Here.
Yes, indeed I will. Forget it, 'cause that big fat moon's gonna shine like a spoon, and we're gonna let it, you know we won't regret it. Kick your shoes off, do not fear. Bring that bottle of whatever you have over here. Woody Hayfist, thank you.
Oh, Patrick. If you go to the North Country Fair, yeah, Bob Dylan arrived here one November in a snowstorm, had his city shoes on and walking through the snow, and of course the snow got into his shoes, and he was an uncomfortable dude all night long. Wasn't used to the North Country. Anyway, that was Patrick Troiani, and he's as good as ever. Moving on, we've got a fellow that plays with us out the Stagecoach pretty often. Wonderful bass player, but he's a guitar player too. Singer, instrument maker. Been here, I picked him up on the road, hitchhiking one day. And we haven't stopped playing music ever since. This is Buddy Thompson.
Howdy, folks. Well, I heard Patrick did one Bob Dylan tune. So maybe I'll try another one here if I can remember it.
It ain't no use to sit and wonder why, babe, if you don't know by now. And it ain't no use to sit and wonder why, babe, because it'll never do somehow. When your rooster crows at the break of dawn, look out your window, babe, and I'll be gone. You're the reason that I'm traveled in on, but don't think twice, it's all right. And it ain't no use in calling out my name, gal, just like you never done before. And it ain't no use in calling out my name, gal, I can't hear you anymore. Still I'm wishing there's something you would do or say, try to make me change my mind and stay. But we never did too much talking anyway, but don't think twice, it's alright. In turning on your love light, babe, that light, that light that I ain't never know. Ain't no use in turning on your love light, babe, because I'm on the dark side of that road. I'm not saying treated me unkind. You could have loved me a little bit better, babe, but I don't mind. You just sort of wasted some of my precious time, but don't think twice, it's all right. And I'm headed down that long, lonely road, babe, where I'm bound. I can't tell, but goodbye's just too good a word, babe, so I guess I'll just say farewell. Well, I'm thinking and I'm wondering, I'm walking down the road. I once loved a woman, a child I've been told. I gave her my heart, but she wanted my soul. Don't think twice, it's all right. I said, don't think twice, it's all right.
Thank you. Hey, Bill, you want to pick your banjo on a tune? I was thinking of doing a train song in the key of E.
E?
Yeah. Oh, right. Just three chords. It's, I think you've heard it. Maybe I've done it. Let's see. One day a train was passing, I heard it. Close enough for rock and roll. Yeah. Yeah.
Train was passing, I caught it coming by. I looked this whole world over under God's blue sky. My babe stood there weeping as I was looking back. I left my baby crying in that smoke along the track. Bye bye so long, until I come back home you'll be my dream. Bye bye so long, there's lots of places that I never seen. I'll always be a drifter, but I'll come drifting back. The way I left you crying in that smoke along the track.
Let's see here.
I like to keep on moving, it helps me when I'm blue. I get the urge to travel, that's all I want to do. I just can't seem to settle down because I like to roam. And when I hear that whistle blow, I've got to move along. Bye-bye so long, there's something down the track that's calling me. Bye-bye so long, I guess that's just the way I'll always be. When I hear that whistle blow, I hurry home to pack. Kiss my baby crying in that smoke along the track. You know my baby loves me, I love my baby too, but she don't understand me when I'm feeling blue. I get the urge to travel, don't try to hold me back. I'll only leave you crying in that smoke along the track. Bye-bye so long, I hate to leave you, but I got to go. Bye-bye so long, it's coming now, just hear that whistle blow. It'll be here in a minute, you'll wave and I'll look back. I'm gonna leave you crying in that smoke along the track. I'm gonna leave you crying in that smoke along the track.
Thank you, Bill.
Thank you.
Been too long since I played that. All right, Buddy Thompson, wonderful bass player for us at the Stagecoach. Okay, moving on. My co-hoot, Dick Barker, plays ballads, sells songs, tells stories to us, does it so well. This is Dick Barker.
Thank you.
Thank you. Last week, when we got here, we were still on our way home from our trip to California. And while we were out there down at the beach, there were a lot of people surfing, doing things like that in the water. I've always been a little concerned about what else is swimming out there. So, made me think of this old song. The most chivalrous fish of the ocean, to the ladies forbearing and mild. Though his record be dark, the man-eating shark will eat neither woman nor child. He dines upon the seamen and skippers, and a tourist his hunger o'ersways, and a fresh cabin boy will inspire him with joy if he's past the maturity age. A doctor, a lawyer, a preacher, he'll gobble one any fine day. But the ladies, God bless them, he'll only address them politely and go on his way. I can readily cite you an instance when a lovely young lady of Bream, who was tender and sweet and delicious to eat, fell into the bay with a scream. She struggled, she flounced in the water, and signaled in vain for her bark. She'd surely been drowned if she hadn't been found by a chivalrous man-eating shark. He bowed in a manner most polished, thus soothing her impulses wild. Don't be frightened, he said, I've been properly bred, and will eat neither woman nor child. Then he offered his fin, and she took it. Such gallantry none can dispute. As the vessel they neared, the passengers cheered, and a broadside was fired in salute. And they soon stood alongside the vessel. A life-saving dinghy was lowered, with the pick of the crew and her relatives too, and the mate and the skipper aboard. They got her aboard in a jiffy, and the shark stood attention the while. Then he raised on his flipper and made up the skipper and went on his way with a smile. This shows that the prince of the ocean, to the ladies forbearing and mild, though his record be dark, the man-eating shark will eat neither woman nor child. Thank you. Well, there's kind of a long ballad. I've been known to do those occasionally. And with all the news that's been, oops, we're apparently you're only going to hear half of it. thank you, Jack. With all the news that's been going on recently, I thought this might be about right for tonight. If I can find the right key. The sons of the prophets are brave men and bold, quite unaccustomed to fear. But the bravest of all was a man, I am told, named Abdul Bulamir. When they needed a man to encourage the van or to harass a foe from the rear, storm, fort, or redoubt, they had only to shout for Abdul Bulamir. This son of the desert, in battle aroused, could split 20 men on his spear. A terrible creature when sober or soused was Abdul Bulamir. Now the heroes were plenty and well known to fame, who fought in the ranks of the Tsar. But the bravest of all was a man by the name of Ivan Shkavinsky Skivar. He could imitate Irving, play poker and pool, strum on the Spanish guitar. In fact, quite the cream of the Muscovite team was Ivan Shkavinsky Skivar. The ladies all loved him, his rivals were few. He could drink them all under the bar. As gallant or tank, there was no one to rank with Ivan Shkavinsky Skivar. One day this bold Russian had shouldered his gun, donned his most truculent sneer. Downtown he did go, where he trod on the toe of Abdul Bulamir. Young man, said Bulbul, has your life grown so dull that you're anxious to end your career? Violin, fiddle, no, you have trod on the toe of Abdul Bulamir. So take your last look at the sunshine and brook, send your regrets to the Tsar. For by this I imply you are going to die, Mr. Ivan Shkavinsky Skivar. Said Ivan, my friend, your remarks in the end will avail you but a little, I fear. For you ne'er will survive to repeat them alive, Mr. Abdul Bulamir. Then that bold Mameluke do his trusty skabook, and with a great cry of Allah Akbar, and with murderous intent he ferociously went for Ivan Shkavinsky Skivar. They parried and thrust, they sidestepped and cussed, of blood they spilled a great part. And the philologist blokes, who seldom crack jokes, say that hash was first made on that spot. They fought all that night, neath the pale yellow moon. The din, it was heard from afar. Huge multitudes came, so great was the fame of Abdul and Ivan Skivar. As Abdul's long knife was extracting the life, in fact he had shouted, huzzah! He felt himself struck by that wily cow muck, Count Ivan Shkavinsky Skivar. The Sultan drove by in his red-breasted fly, expecting the victor to cheer. But he only drew nigh just to hear the last sigh of Abdul Bulamir. Tsar Petrovich, too, in his spectacles blue, drove up in his new crested car. He arrived just in time to exchange the last line with Ivan Shkavinsky Skivar. There's a tomb rises up where the blue Danube rolls. Graved there in characters clear, our stranger when passing, oh pray for the soul of Abdul-Abul-Amir. A splash in the Black Sea, one dark moonless night, caused ripples to spread wide and far. It was made from a sack, fitting close to the back of Ivan Skivinsky Skibar. A Muscovite maiden, her lone vigil keeps neath the light of the pale polar star. And the name that she murmurs so oft as she weeps is Ivan Skivinsky Skivar. Thank you very much.
True Tales from Dick Barker. All right. Next up, we have a fellow that came in late, but he usually gets here. This is his 45th time with us. This is Will Gilson.
Starting to feel a little older now that I've made it to 45. I've lived here for 3.5 years, so what kind of percentage is that? How many can you have a year? How many do we have a year? Dick? 52? This is a song about hiking in the woods back east. Children running off down the road.
It's definitely a I can do today.
Thank you. We're gonna change it up here a little bit. You can see by the look what I found backstage sort of thing. Pete and I have done this song before and we're gonna do it again.
We have?
Huh? Have we?
No.
We just did it upstairs.
Oh, okay.
So one time mellow with just two guitars and then come in after one time there. All right. Sorry. 1, 2, 3, 4.
Wait for me.
One more time, a little quiet.
Bill Gilson and the background boys there. All right. And now we have our historian, teller of great tales about the songs he sings. This is Jack Hyler.
After that number, I need to sit down. No story about this first one that I know. Margaret and I were trying to cope with a put together an old secondhand refrigerator today all day, and I didn't have time to do any research on this number. Oh, can't you see yon little turtle dove sitting under a mulberry tree? She sits and mourns for her true love, as I, my love, will mourn for thee, as I will mourn for thee. So fare ye well, my little turtle dove, and fare thee well for a while. But I'll come back to the woman that I love, though I go 10,000 miles, my dear, though I go 10,000 miles. 10,000 miles is very far away for you to return to me. Though I must sit and lament a well-a-day, my tears you shall not see, my love. My tears you shall not see. Oh, fare thee well, my little turtle dove, and fare thee well for a while. But I'll come back to the woman that I love, though I go 10,000 miles, my dear, though I go 10,000 miles. The crow that's black, my little turtle dove, shall turn its feathers white, ere I be false to the woman that I love. The noonday shall be night, my dear. The noonday shall be night. Oh, can you see yon little turtle dove sitting under a mulberry tree? This one's quite a change of pace. 2 weeks ago, before we went down to Colorado, it's the week before Veterans Day, but I sang three service songs. And since Veterans Day is just barely behind us, I moved to sing another one. My hitch was up Monday, ain't a dog soldier no more. They gave me all that money, so much my pockets was sore. More dough than I could use, re-enlistment blues. Went to town around Tuesday, got me a big feather bed. I'll get a job tomorrow, tonight I'll sleep like I'm dead. And wake up when I choose, re-enlistment blues. Hit the bars around Wednesday, maybe some friends on my own, oh, some friends on my own. I found a pretty baby, she couldn't leave me alone. Just can't be buying booze, real Lisbon blues. Woke up around Thursday, the walls was moving, I swear they was moving, I swear. I reached down in my trousers and all my pockets was bare. That gal was sure bad news, real Lisbon blues. Went back around Friday, asked for a free glass of beer. Just give me one little beer. That gal forgot to know me. She just said, no credit here. Did I give her a bruise? Re-endless mud blues. That jail was cold Saturday, just like those people in town. They ain't got time to know ya, just time to put your way down. A guy can't help but lose, re-enlistment blue. Re-enlisted on Sunday.
Jack Hyler singing the blues. All right, getting up toward 300?
That one wasn't. The one before was 281.
281? Uh-huh. 281 songs without having the words here.
Well, I'll make 300 this fall. Next summer.
All right. Moving on, we get our poet laureate of Jackson Hole, and he tells us a strange point of view sometimes, but very amusing. This is Bradley Parker.
Yeah, maybe I'll try sitting down. That's something I don't do often. Sit down and play. Ooh, maybe I won't touch that. I think I'll play a blues tune here. This morning, didn't feel that bad. Last night was definitely not one of the worst I ever had. Well, I ate a nice dinner, drank a few drinks. Didn't think about your love, baby, no matter what you think. Back in my hotel room, went straight to bed. Didn't moan, didn't cry, didn't wish I was dead. I'm alright. I'm alright. Oh yeah, well you know I'm alright. Baby, I'm all right without you. Woke up this morning, did not have the blues. Pulled up my tube socks, laced up my running shoes. Went up to the reservoir and jogged a mile or two. And I didn't think about your sweet kisses, love. I wasn't missing you. Back in my hotel room, made phone calls. Clean sheets on a made-up bed, artwork on the wall. I'm all right. Baby, I'm all right. And I picked up the phone and said, hey, yeah, oh, I'm all right, baby. All right without you. Thank you. woke this morning, sat up in my bed, gnawing in my gut, aching in my head. Well, I walked into the bathroom to the medicine chest. There were sleeping pills and razor blades and all the rest. But I was in control, I was so relaxed. Found my favorite kind of dental floss, minute I'm waxed. I'm alright, I got my dental floss. I'm alright, I'm getting in the nooks and crannies. Well, I'm alright, baby, I'm alright without you. I'm alright, mama, I'm alright without you. Well, I'm alright, sugar, who needs it anyhow?
Alright, it's a Loudon Wainwright song called, All Right, Baby Without You. Yeah, that's it. And this is a song, by Richard Thompson. I decided to play songs I haven't played in a long time here and see if I could actually do it. It's a little mind control. Today Will and I went to a Memory Max meeting where we remembered people's names. And this guy couldn't remember 120 people's names. Will and I, between the both of us, don't have that many brain cells left, so. That'd be pretty tough.
Said James, it my opinion, there's nothing in this world that beats a Vincent Black Lightning and a red-headed girl. Now Nortons and Indians and Greedies just won't do. They don't have a soul like Vincent 52. And he reached for her hand, handed her the keys. He said, I have no further use for these. I see angels and ariels and leather and chrome swooping down from the heavens to carry me home. And he gave her one last kiss and died. Yes, he gave her his Vincent ride. Thanks very much.
Let's take us a short break here. Be back here in 10 minutes and we'll get going again. Have another round.
Okay, if this has been a mini enough break for everyone, we're going to get started right away, and so we'll do another round. Thank you for the few of you who are still here, and we're going to start off once again with Bill Briggs.
Oh, after we finished at the coach last night, a couple of fellows came up and introduced themselves, and they're from Norway, and they're training on skiing at Snow King now. But one of the fellows was an Olympic gold medalist in cross country back in the early 90s. And
92.
He lives 92?
Yeah, and he got 3 gold medals and 1 silver medal.
Really?
At the Olympics.
Wow.
Wow. Anyway, he lives up in the northern part of Norway. It's above the Arctic Circle.
Ski all year round.
Can't do much else but ski up there. We drove up there back in 57. It was really quite an experience. I hadn't been above the Arctic Circle before. The sun staying out all day long and night long meant you could do a climb which would otherwise stretch into the night. So I picked out the biggest mountain there and the longest ridge and put up a new route on this mountain, which is right near his home.
Can you
okay.
pronounce it?
What's that?
Can you pronounce the mountain you put the new route?
Jægervatn.
Good for you.
So it was one of the most exciting climbs I ever did, and it's right near his home. Anyway, this is a Norwegian song, which I have never done before. And I only know one, I learned it in Norwegian. And then found some English words for it.
Gammel bandemann som skulder og løfter opp, som skulder og løfter opp, som skulder og løfter opp, løfter opp, så
Buddy Thompson, come up and help me out on this song.
Sit down because I forgot my guitar step.
Yeah, okay.
Copyrighted in 1936. There are theories and systems of skiing. One thing I surely have found, while skiing's confined to the wintertime, drinking is good all year round. Oh, here's to the trail and the mountaintop. Give me my glass and my bar.
trail on the mountain top. Here's to the skier that dares, but give me my glass and my bottle, my bottle, to drive away all of my cares. Howdy, 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 dodge all the trees he sees, rocks that lie hidden in the trail. But the thing I fear most is the heebie-jeebies and the slowness takes a hideous swell. Oh, here's to the trail and the mountain top. Here's to the skier that dares, but give me my glass and my bottle, my bottle, to drive away all of my cares. Howdy, 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 howdy. And here's to the race from the summit. Bottle of brew at each gate. You may just check once for the style hung that Kelly's me always takes straight. Oh, here's to the trail and the mountain top. Here's to the skier that dares, that gave me my glass and my bottle, my bottle, to drive away all of my cares. Howdy, 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 howdy,
howdy, howdy, howdy, howdy, howdy, howdy, howdy, howdy,
Bill Briggs with Buddy Thompson. Okay, here he is again. Pete Carney.
Hey! I'm never going second again. How can you follow that? Impossible. Let's sit down. That's the worst thing you could do to me. This I learned. It's a song about Texas, and I was going to do this because Jennifer Kronberger is going to come, and she's pretty much a Texas kind of girl. In fact, she's starting a new band with Melissa Harrison, and they're going to be called the something, the Dixie Chicks, Western style. I couldn't think of a better name, but I will. Just leave the name up to me. The name's taken care of, I just don't have it yet. You know, we all love to tease Texans up here. Unless there's a great big one in the audience and then kinda back off. But they are fun to tease. And the Austin Lounges wrote this song, and they're actually from Texas, so they're forgiven. And when I get to the end of this, I'm gonna really blow it, but that's okay. I've done that before too. Well, Texas is a big state, north and south and east and west. Alaska doesn't really count, we're bigger than the rest. You can waltz across it though, so grab your yellow rose and sing another Texas song. This is how it goes. One more stupid song about Texas. Yahoo! 4 miles and miles it rambles on.
Biggest egos, biggest hair, biggest liars anywhere. Let's sing another stupid Texas song. By God, we're just so proud to be from Texas. And even of that pride, we're proud, and we're proud of that pride too. I'm proud about our home state is the proudest pride indeed. We're proud to be Americans until we can't secede. One more stupid song about Texas. You've heard it all before, so sing along. Biggest belt buckles and bows, gotta love that Texas toast. Just sing another stupid Texas song. Our accents are the drawliest, our howdies are the yawliest, our Lone Star flag's the waviest, our fried steak the cream graviest, our rattlesnakes the coiliest, our beaches are the oiliest, our politicians most corrupt, our speed traps most abrupt, our guitars are the twangiest, our guns are the kerplangiest. Our cows are the longhorniest, our yodels are forlorniest, our cook-offs are the chilliest, our wailing is the williest, our sausage is the smokiest, our neighbors are the yokiest, from Texas down to El Paso and Dalhart down to Barnes. Every spot in Texas got what you need, what you're looking for. Aren't you glad that Texas put the stars up in the sky? If heaven isn't Texas, then I don't want to die. One more stupid song about Texas. Just because we're bragging don't mean it's wrong. Biggest heads and biggest hearts, biggest various body parts. Let's sing another stupid Texas song. One more blustering, bumptious, bald-faced, brazen, high-toned, high-flown, high-toned, dander-up, pantering, pompous, Texas puffed-up, snotty, swaggering Texas song.
Conrad Diesler and Hank Carr, the guys in the Awesome Lounge Lizards. And one of these days I'll get that, but not right away. Okay, you ready, Doug? We're gonna make up for that one by doing something worthwhile. All right, Hank. This is a truck driving song. Will. I knew he'd weasel out on me.
Come on, Logo. Come on, you will let you go.
You're on stage, man.
I know I was in.
Okay, I'm ready.
This is a truck driving song. That's a Red Sovine tune. I buy a big freighter liner and I make my last payment today. I drive to all points out of New York City to L.A. Where my little woman smiles as I pack up to leave her. I'll soon be back. She's got the fever, she's a believer. I took the freight line of fever. Well, the highway running on the highway by the San Antonio. And I pass an old freight train making his way back. Bobbins of pale, he's blowing that freight train off of the rails. He's got the fever, he's got the freight line of fever. Now, he's got the fever. He's got the freight line of fever. I said, hey, big red, won't you carry that cigarette back?
smoking driver, and he's gonna drive all the way back. Oh, it's a big, black, long round to the driver. It's a West Coast round. He's got the fever. He's got the gray line of fever.
Moving on, here we get my old buddy up here, Spuddy Thompson.
Hello again. I thought I'd better find it just in case. Let's see. Made up my mind what I want to do yet here. You want to hear something sad and mournful with a moral to it?
Why not?
Okay. This is a Bob Dylan tune off an album that didn't make huge a splash, you know, but I always kind of liked it. There's all these stories that you listen to them and you think, well, gosh, that means something. And then you listen to it again and you try to figure out exactly what it means, and it's hard to get to the bottom of it, you know? That's one of those songs that you might think this is about the people who come through in the Winnebagos in the summer, but I don't think that's what it's about, actually. We all tend to move around a lot. I pity the poor immigrant who wishes he would have stayed home. He uses all of his powers to do evil, but in the end, he's always left all alone. That man who with his finger steals and who lies with every breath, who passionately hates his life and likewise fears his death. I pity the poor immigrant whose strengths all stand in vain, whose heaven is like iron sights and whose tears are like the rain, whose visions in their final end must shatter like the glass. I pity the poor immigrant when his gladness comes to pass. I pity the poor immigrant who tramples through the mud, whose mouth is filled with laughing and whose town is built on blood, who eats but is not satisfied, who hears but does not see, who falls in love with wealth itself and
Sam turns his back on me.
That song is about something. Maybe we can do kind of one of them there jam sessions, you know? Hey, Bill, you want to play a tune? Want to pick up your banjo, Bill, maybe? Cool. What could we do? See if maybe Hank wants to play too if he's in the neighborhood. Hey, Hank, are you out there? Yo, Hank. I knew this mic was here for something. How about D?
Dog?
We got a key now. All we need is a song, huh? Feeling bad.
Oh, yeah.
Well, I'm going down this road feeling bad. Yes, I'm going down this road feeling bad. Bad luck is all I ever had, Lord, Lord. And I ain't gonna be treated this way, dear. And I'm going where the climate suits my clothes. Going where the climate suits my clothes. I'm going where the climate suits my clothes, Lord, Lord, and I ain't going to be treated this way.
Hey, Bill.
Shoes fit my foot. Yes, these $2 shoes hurt my foot. Takes a $10 shoe to fit my foot, Lord, Lord, and I ain't gonna be treated this way. And I'm going where the water tastes like wine. Yes, I'm going where the water tastes like wine. I'm going where the water tastes like wine, Lord, Lord, and I ain't gonna be treated this way.
Hey.
I'm going where the climate suits my clothes. Yeah, I'm going where the climate suits my clothes. I'm going where the climate suits my clothes, Lord, Lord, and I ain't gonna be treated this way. Yes, I'm going where them chilling winds don't blow. I'm going where them chilling winds don't blow. I'm going where them chilling winds don't blow, Lord, Lord, and I ain't gonna be treated this way. I'm headed down this long lonesome road. Well, I'm headed down this old lonesome road. I'm headed down this lonesome road, Lord, Lord, and I ain't gonna be treated this way. And I ain't gonna be treated this way.
Thank you.
Buddy Thompson and his quartet. Yeah. All right, moving on. Get my co-hoot up here. Get him away from his camera. Get his guitar in place and have him sing us another ballad or two here. Dick Barker.
Last week, I forgot that we had Veterans Day coming up, and Jack and his singing brought that to my attention tonight. There's a song that, this comes from the Second World War, and it was during the Pacific Theater that was written by a man by the name of Frank Lesher. He was a PFC with the Special Services, not Special Forces, but Special Services. And of course he went on after the war to do great things on Broadway. But as a young man in the Army, why he wrote this song, and it's about a Congressional Medal of Honor winner by the name of Roger Young. Oh, they've got no time for glory in the infantry. Oh, they've got no time for praises loudly sung. But in all the soldier's heart and all the infantry lives the name of Roger Young. Shines the name of Roger Young. Fought and died for the men he marched among. To the everlasting glory of the end. The story of Private Roger Young. On the island of New Georgia, way out of order. Next word. It was he who drew the fire of the enemy, that a company of men might live to fight. And beneath the silent coral of the enemy stood the man we hail tonight. Stood the man, Roger Young, fought and died for the men he marched among. To the everlasting glory of the infantry lives the story of Private Roger Young. On the island of New Georgia in the Solomons stands a simple wooden cross alone to tell that beneath the silent coral of the Solomons sleeps a man, sleeps a man, remembered well. Sleeps a man, Roger Young, fought and died for the men he marched among. To the everlasting glory of the infantry lives the story of Private Roger Young. I think they should have more songs about people like that who gave so much for the rest of us. Well, we've had songs about Texas. We've had songs by Woody Guthrie. So I'm going to combine them. This is a song that Woody wrote, but he never recorded this song. And it was recorded, I believe, in 1948 or 49 by Cisco Houston. Down in that scrub oak country, to the southeast Texas coast, Gulf, there used to ride a brakeman. A brakeman double tough, he worked the town of Kilgore and Longview 12 miles down. The strangers all said Little East Texas Red was the meanest bull around. If you rode by night, by broad daylight, in the wintry wind or the sun, you would always see Little East Texas Red just a sportin' his smooth running gun. Well, the tail got switched down the stems and manes. Everybody said the meanest bull on the shiny irons was Little East Texas Red. It was on a cold and wintry night, morn, let's get that right. It was on a cold and windy morn, long towards 9 or 10, when a couple of boys on the hunt of a job stood in that wintry wind. Hungry and cold, they knocked on the doors of the working folks around for a piece of meat or a spud or two just to boil their stew around. Well, East Texas Red, he came down the line. He swung off old number 2. He kicked their bucket over a bush, dumped out all of their stew. One traveler said, Mr. East Texas Red, you'd better get your business fixed right, 'cause you're gonna ride your little black train just 1 year from tonight. Well, Red just laughed as he climbed down the bank. He swung on the side of a wheeler, and the boys caught a tanker to Seminole, then west to Amarillo. They got them a job of oil field work. They followed the pipeline down. It took them lots of places till 1 year had rolled around. Then on a cold and windy morn, caught them a Gulf-bound train. They shivered and shook with dough in their clothes to that scrub oak flats again, over hills of sand in that hard froze land. They knew what they must do. past the town of Kilgore and on to old Longview, with their warm suit of clothes and their overalls, they walked into a store. They paid the man for some meat and stuff, just to boil their stew once more. They walked the ties to the cinder dump. They came to the same old spot, where 1 year ago Little East Texas Red had dumped their last stew pot. Well, the smoke from their fire went higher and higher. Red came down the line with his head held low in the blizzardy wind. He waved bold number nine. He walked the ties to the cinder dump. He came to the same old spot. There were the same two men again around that same stew pot. Red hollered and said as he came down the bank, you'd better pack up and run, 'cause if you're still here tomorrow morn, I'll get my smooth running gun. When the boys turned around and he saw their face, he started to back away. One traveler said, Mr. East Texas Red, you're gonna die today. Red went to his knees and he hollered, please, don't pull your trigger on me. I never did get my business fixed. Oh, let me live, said he. Well, a gun wheeled out of an overcoat, it played the old one too, and Red lay dead while the other two men sat down to eat their stew. Thank you.
Dick Barker. Stories. Life to tell. Another storyteller here is Jack Hyler. I'm not sure what he's got for us here. He's singing old songs that he used to know way back before we ever were around. It's Jack Hyler.
Well, I had planned to sing something, but the cowboy song, and I really can't, I don't want to do it. And Greg's not here. I want him to hear it. It's a second version of a good old cowboy song, and I was gonna have to read the words, but I think I'll have to improvise here. I was just looking for some songs. That's a mistake. All right, I'll sing an old, old ballad. This is about a ship sailed under Sir Francis Drake against the Spanish Armada. As dawn came over the cold North Sea, there lay at anchor the Golden Vanity. As she lay in the lowlands lonesome alone, lay in the lowlands alone. As dawn came over the cold North Sea, there came upon them the Spanish reveille. As they lay in the lowlands lonesome alone, lay in the lowlands alone. Then up spoke the captain, said, what shall we do?
We cannot flee them, so swift will they pursue. And they'll sink us in the lowlands, lonesome alone. Sink us in the lowlands alone. Then up spoke the cabin boy, said, what will you give me if I send her to the bottom of the cold North Sea? If I sink her in the lowlands, lonesome alone, sink her in the lowlands alone. Oh, I'll give you gold, and I'll make you free, and my eldest, eldest daughter, your wedded wife will be. If you'll sink her in the lowlands, lonesome alone, sink her in the lowlands alone. Then he swam through the water with tools made to fit, and he bored 9 holes in the bottom of that ship. And he sank her in the lowlands, lonesome alone, sank her in the lowlands alone. Oh, captain, be a man of your word. Throw me a rope and take me on board. For I've sunk her in the lowlands, lonesome alone, sunk her in the lowlands alone. Oh, I won't give you gold, and I won't make you free, and my eldest, eldest daughter, your wedded wife won't be. Though you've sunk her in the lowlands, lonesome alone, you've sunk her in the lowlands alone. Then he threw up his hands, and a prayer breathed he, and he sank to the bottom of the cold North Sea. And his ghost haunts the lowlands, lonesome alone. His ghost haunts the lowlands alone.
Thank you. I was kind of caught by surprise because Dick's song, Roger Young, put me back in the war mode again. I haven't thought a lot about the war over the years since, but ever since Private Ryan, I saw Saving Private Ryan, it wiped me out, just took me right back to combat situations. And I had to sit there in a seat for a little while until I got enough energy to get up and walk out. Incidentally, I think it's a movie everyone should see. It's the best anti-war movie I can imagine because it's so realistic. But when I was sitting right there and Dick was singing, I all at once thought of a peculiar little situation. At the end of the war, I was in China in a little valley called Luzhou, the Luzhou Valley. And Luzhou, I'd say the valley was about the size of the Fall Creek end of Jackson Hole, a small valley surrounded by mountains, very, very dry, very arid. Well, anyway, 30 years later, Margaret and I were in Japan. And we were having dinner with the Japanese, Mr. and Mrs. Wakabayashi. And he spoke maybe 100 words of English, and Margaret spoke maybe 50 words of Japanese, and I spoke maybe 3 words of Japanese. But we went out to dinner together. And as we came along, we came by a Chinese restaurant. And Mr. Wakabayashi pointed and said to me, you like? I said, yes, we like very much. And so we went in, and this is in Japan, mind you, and we sat down, and I said, I learned to like Chinese food, World War II. He said, me too. And I said, you were in China, World War II. Hey. I said, I was, at the end of the war, I was in a little place called Luzhou, and his eyes just got big like that. Me too. And here we've been on opposite sides in a combat situation in a valley where my voice could have been heard all the way across the valley, and may have been. It was very moving. Here we were having dinner together. And your Roger Young song brought that back to me. It sort of took my mind off what I was going to sing, because I decided to save that for Greg. Margaret, what'll I sing? It's a raining and hailing, and the moon gives no light. My horses can't travel. It's a dark, stormy night. Oh, I'm grand for to leave you. I'll write you my mind. My mind is to travel and to leave you behind. My mind is to travel and to leave you behind.
Thank you. Bill sings a version, sings a song that has that, those stanzas in it.
Yeah, same words there. But, a lengthy song about coming out to Wyoming. All right, Jack Hyler. Always good stuff. Love the stories, Jack.
Well, that one got me.
All right, skipped over a fellow here. Back with us again for his 45th time. This is Will Gilson.
Thank you.
up her wings. I guess this must be the place. I can't tell one from another. Did I find you or you find me? There was a time before we were born. If someone asks, this is where I'll be. Drifting in and out. Hi-ho, sing into my mouth. Out of all these kinds of people, you've got a face with a view. I'm just an animal looking for a home. Share the space for the moment or two, and you love me till my heart stops. Love me till I'm dead. Eyes light up, eyes look through you. They cover up the blank spots and hit me on the head.
Thank you. I don't know all the words to this song, but I'm going to do it anyway. If you know the words, come on up. Don't be shy. That's what Hootenanny is. You can come up and tell me what they are, or come sing them with me.
Lay down, little doggies, lay down, for we all gotta sleep on the cold, cold ground. The wind's blowing colder and the sun's going down. So lay down, little doggies, lay down. We left on this old beef trail a few months ago. We blistered in the sun and we froze in the snow. In 2 days we're coming to a packing house town. So lay yourselves down, little doggies, lay down. Found some foul water, we drunk and got sick. Flames, old Mexico. Got lost in a blind canyon, tippy-toeing around. So lay yourselves down, little doggies, lay down. Lay down, little doggies, lay down. For we all gotta sleep on the cold, cold ground. The wind's blowing colder and the sun's going down. So lay down, little doggies, lay down.
I hadn't heard that for a great long time. All right, Will Gilson. And now we get back with us again, our singer-songwriter, Mr. Bradley Parker.
Yes, I'm last. I think I'm last, right? Am I last? I was born that way, so.
New Year's baby?
No, I was a New Year's baby. I was born last. Okay, so I went to Kmart today. There's lots of good things in Kmart. And I was checking out the Christmas lights, because those are something I'm very fond of. Christmas lights, they blink and they go on. You can pretend you're in like a disco and stuff and put them all over your house. Right, Will?
It's your house, Brad.
Yeah, we've done that before, haven't we? Pretend we're in a disco. And I thought about how Christmas is right around the corner, folks. It's Christmas. I have my Christmas shopping done. I don't know about you, but I'm sure all of you are procrastinators and aren't as well-rounded as I am. So this is a song called Suddenly It's Christmas. I haven't bought one Christmas present. Suddenly it's Christmas right after Halloween. Forget about Thanksgiving, it's just a buffet in between. There's lights and tinsel in the window, and they're stocking up the shelves. Santa's slaving at the North Pole in his sweatshop full of elves. There's gotta be a climax to the day that Christ was born. Well, the halls are decked with pumpkins and ears of Indian corn, dragging through the falling leaves in a one-horse open sleigh. Suddenly it's Christmas 7 weeks before the day. Suddenly it's Christmas, the longest holiday. When they say season's greetings, they mean just what they say. It's a season, it's a holiday. Retail eternity, and it's not over till it's over and you throw away the tree. Outside it's positively balmy in the air, nary a nip. Suddenly it's Christmas, unbutton and unzip. Yes, they're working overtime, Santa's little runts. Christmas comes but once a year and goes on for 3 months. Christmas carols in December and November too. It's no wonder we're so depressed when everything is through. Suddenly it's January, let's bring old anxiety. Here comes another heartache shaped like a Valentine. Suddenly it's Christmas, the longest holiday. When they say season's greetings, they mean just what they say. It's a season, it's a marathon, retail eternity. And it's not over till it's over and you throw away the tree. No, it's not over till it's over and you throw away the tree. No, it's not over till it's over and you throw away the tree. There you go. Will Gill, we'll have Will Gill up here for a...
Brad, you should sing that every week for the next 3.
Oh yeah, it works, right?
He plays it every morning just to remind himself.
Yeah, Will and I haven't really practiced this song too much.
I know it.
But he says he knows it, yeah. I know it anyhow. This is a Dan Hicks tune.
Something is love.
Believe it's something.
What's it something?
But something is love. Simply.
Simply.
You know you can't forget it.
Forget.
Simply. Wanna make a bet.
Make a bet.
Simply. When trouble comes away. Simply. Is what I have to say. You gotta believe.
Believe.
And you will surely find it if you believe.
Believe.
It's sort of easy, man. Come on, believe. And then something up above.
What is something?
That something is love. Believe it's something.
What's the something?
That something is love. Believe it's something.
What's the something?
That something is love. Believe it's something.
What's the something?
That something is love. Well, it's a drag when you're down, down, down. You gotta believe.
said, well, it's a crime. We know down, 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 you gotta believe in love. Trouble comes away. Simply is what I have to say. Gotta believe in you, it's surely fine. And if you believe, it's sure to ease your mind. Believe in that something up above. What is it, something?
The something is love.
Believe in something.
What's it, something?
The something is love. Believe in something.
What's it, something?
The something is love.
Believe in something. What's it, something?
The something is love. But I'm a deep down, 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 deep
down, deep down, deep.
Something is love, believe in something.
What's it, something?
The something is love, well it's a drag. When you're down, 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 you gotta believe in love. Well it's a crime. When you're down, 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 you gotta believe in love. Love. Thanks.
Tonight, tomorrow morning.
Sometime between 3 and 6 in the morning, set your alarm, look out the window. If you see any stars, take a look. If you don't, go back to bed, but you have another chance tomorrow. Supposed to be the biggest meteor shower that's been seen in our lifetime, even my lifetime.
Really?
Yeah.
Yeah. Once in 100 years, is this?
Yeah, at least.
Yeah. All right, a meteor shower, not to be missed. Okay.
New times.
3 to 6 in the morning.
And of course, it won't be much good after dawn begins, so it better be 3 and 4:30, something like that.
You got two chances, tomorrow and the next day.
Last time I looked at the sky, it didn't look very good for tomorrow morning. Which is fine, then I
can
sleep.
Hey, we got one more. Oh. Hank, you gonna do it?
Sure.
All right.
River?
Oh, that's
what do you think?
So where can we start out? Are you ready, gentlemen?
Which is first?
Yeah.
Tennessee Waltz.
Thank you.
Already. Just let me know what it's going to be. I prefer to know.
They're both in G.
All right.
I'm surprised. Red Wing.
Red Wing.
Who kicks it off?
I will.
Okay.
Well, excuse me, we'll start again.
Our program for tonight. Thank you all. Next week we'll start at the same time, but the week after we're going to try to go back to that 7 o'clock hour. Maybe a little more people will come. This is a slow time of year. It picks up again toward Thanksgiving, and let's see what the 7 o'clock time does week after next. Okay? Thank you all for coming.